Life is a marvel. The realm of thoughts is that of endless possibility. And more recently, I've been trying to keep close track of my thoughts. When you try to catalog the thoughts that run through your head, it almost seems like certain insanity. And in a nutshell, our lives encompass an endless stream of endless thoughts. Chief among them is why, followed by right and wrong, or positive and negative, or dark and light. I think after the curiosity of why, all thoughts sort of dance between what we call good and bad. I don't believe there's any thoughts we have that we don't ascribe this sort of value to, either consciously or subconsciously. And thus this sort of involuntary tool we use to measure our reality becomes our compass for truth. You can tell yourself that good is bad or that bad is good, but at the end of the day, I don't think you're fooling yourself even when you allow yourself to be a fool. I don't believe we escape anything in life, and there's always a price we will pay for whatever sacrifice we choose. Every single choice we make is at the sacrifice of the choice that we didn't make. It's funny because often when I think about my life, the things I think that ruined my life in some sense are also the things that have made the greatest story of my life. The reality of success or ruination aside, that brings us back to the question, why? And I guess the answer is that without the trials, there is no tribulation. My only regret for humanity as a whole is that not all are seemingly capable of surviving the trials that make up the stories of their lives. And we see this played out in reality all the time, sort of manifest in Matthew 13:12 or in the Pareto distribution. My thought is that this relates to the narrative we tell ourselves and how we ascribe meaning to it. In essence, are we grateful for or resentful of the experiences we've had, regardless of how we've cataloged them? And is it possible that the chapters of our own lives, when re-examined, are different than how we previously perceived them? When the answer to this very question is yes, that's when we create room to receive more. And only then.